The DLCs just keep rolling in for SNK Heroines Tag Team Frenzy. It's another new character, Jeanne. And with her, we also get a new patch, version 1.13. Not 1.13, that's Minecraft. 1.31, I mean, sorry. This DLC, just like all the other ones we covered for this game, were provided by NIS America, so thank you once again. For the patch, there's nothing all that new here, just some bug fixes. If we take a look at the very pink patch notes, apparently they fixed a bug where the player who got the first strike sometimes didn't get an item, as well as tweaked a move and changed some hitboxes that didn't get updated as intended in the last patch. That's all fine and good, but what we really want to see right now is the new character. Like I said, she's called Jeanne, as in, you know, Joan of Arc, as you probably already guessed. Other than being an actual, you know, real-life historical figure, in this context, she's actually originally from the World Heroes series, which consists of four games. The premise is that someone named Dr. Brown creates a time machine and organizes a tournament where some of history's best fighters compete against each other. Makes sense, right? What else could you possibly do with a time machine? I don't have experience with those games, so I can't quite comment on how well signature moves or anything like that have transitioned, but I'll do the best I can to describe the experience of using this character in SNK Heroines. By the way, I apologize if I didn't really pronounce her name correctly. Controls are again pretty simple and easy to understand. Special moves involve simply pressing the directional buttons and pressing the circle or A button depending if you have the Switch or PS4 game. This is the PlayStation version you're seeing right now, by the way. As you can see, she's using a sword as a weapon. For some reason, I figured she'd be slow in battle, but that's not the case at all. She's actually pretty quick. I guess I instinctually thought, oh, big sword equals slow movements. Like I always say when I play fighting games, I'm not that great at them. There's nuances that go over my head, but at the default difficulty level, I didn't have any problems jumping in and doing decently well in story mode. I usually prefer using characters that have some sort of projectiles, but those are not to be found here. I don't really miss them too much though. This game is called Tag Team Frenzy after all, so the second character can always pick up the slack in that department. There's three different outfits to choose from. The standard one is simply a regular piece of armor. Strangely normal and refreshing considering all the crazy stuff you often see in fighting games. The second outfit is starting to fall in line with the fanservice-y nature of the game, being some sort of samurai-inspired dealio. The third getup is like a super fancy version of the first one. It's gold, if you're using the standard color scheme that is, and it has all sorts of ornamentation and flimflam, just to borrow a term from James May. Jeanne's character is portrayed as being some sort of rich Ojo-sama, complete with the stereotypical oh-ho-ho-ho laugh. I think there are some artistic liberties applied here, but that's fine. If I'm correct at my history here, I'm pretty sure that she definitely is not like a royalty figure, because, first of all, she was born to a peasant family as far as I know, and couldn't even read and write, so yeah. But anyways, I don't think anybody looks at this game and, you know, expects some historical accuracy here. In the end, I quite enjoyed this new character, and hopefully you enjoyed watching this video as well. If you liked the video, remember to leave a like. You can also check out the other DLC videos if you want. I'll do a card or something in the description to point you in the right way if you want to look at those. Thanks again to NIS America for always sending me the DLC for SNK Heroines when they come out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.